Hello candidates, you're most welcome to this session. I'm handling our second term's workbook. You remember where we ended? We had started on topic 6, that was the people of Africa, and we had already looked at migration, whereby we looked at early migration of ethnic groups, and in that discussion we said that we have two kinds of migration, whereby we have the current and the early migration. For early migration, it was already covered, and our center of focus today is current migration. This kind of work is not new to you because you looked at them in right in P6, P5, whereby you discussed a lot about this. So here we are making just a recapitulation of what we had looked at earlier. To begin with, rural migration, we have urban migration, we have rural-urban and urban-rural. So in this aspect, we shall discuss a few. To begin with, rural-rural migration. What is rural-rural migration? Of course you know, but let us say it is the movement of people from one village to another looking for permanent settlement. Any definition, if it is migration, must have the ending statement. Settlement is a key point to note as you are defining the word migration. So when we look at this, there are reasons as to why people are leaving villages A to village B. There are reasons. Reason number one, for farmers, they are looking for fertile lands to grow crops. Two, areas with reliable rainfall, to get areas with better education services. You find that people leave villages and they come to other villages. For example, here Chikajo, people left their areas, Butambala, where they came here to look for better education services, to get areas with better health services. So that one forces people to move from one village to another. And as they come, they impact on the people around. And this one, among others, as they come, it leads to population increase. Not only that, for people who have come to establish settlement, can lead to land conflicts, among others. Anyway, then another kind of migration, we have what we call urban-rural. What is urban? Urban-rural migration? Of course you know it. But here we are saying that urban means town, rural means village. So people are leaving townies, going back to villages. So urban-rural migration refers to the movement of people from townies back to villages to looking for better settlement. And there are reasons as to why those people are leaving. Among others, we have loss of jobs in towns. People may lose jobs and they have nothing to do in town and they resort to going back to villages. Then retirement from jobs in town areas due to old age. There are people who may stay in towns, they have not invested anything, they end up going back to villages because they have nothing to do there due to old age. Disease outbreak, away of the current pandemic. People have decided, apart from me who is still here, have decided to go back to villages to escape that. Then search for enough land for large-scale farming, because in towns there are no enough space for large-scale farming. So here currently the government of Uganda is encouraging people to leave towns and go to villages. And the reasons, among others, is to increase food production, because as much labor is concentrated in town, it becomes very difficult. Two, to reduce on the rate of unemployment. There are vast lands that need to be tilled in order to grow crops so that people get employment. To reduce on crime rates in town, to reduce on overcrowding in town. Then, as we crown up this session, we need to know the difference between the early migration and the current migration. You find that with the current migration today, people migrate to look for better jobs, unlike with early ethnic migration. Today, people migrate to look for better education services, unlike the current, unlike the early ethnic migration. Today, people are migrating to look for better medical services, unlike with early education ale ethnic groups. So, colleagues, dear friends, boys and girls, I'm encouraging you to continue reading ahead of what we have not yet looked at. I know the work is so clear. Here, the activity is attached. You are going to do that work. The area that I've covered is on page 28, but the details are here, and the activity shall be sent. Thank you for attending this session.